Welcome back. So we've got a very lengthy and expensive space station launch coming up. We're rolling out our Mars probes, Mars orbiters, and I guess we're going to do CompSats in the meanwhile. Mo money. Venus, space station. Alright, so. CompSat. That's decent. So let's go to 50 degrees. Basically, we're stuck trying to make money because we ain't got none. Well, I mean, we have $400 million in the bank, but gonna need more than that to unlock the stuff we need. Stage is on, so we'll swap this around for hot staging because we're not going to coast, we're going to hot stage. Let's go. The venerable Corgi launch vehicle. Piano Josh, hey, Mr. Bond. I guess there's a city down there. I'm not off tomorrow. I mean, so like, it's Valve. We have what days we want to take off, but no specific holidays. And so I'm not planning on taking tomorrow off. Holding on to them fairings. Ah, gotcha. Yeah, no, you gotta be careful about. There's actually, I mean, there are scientific studies that prove that unlimited PTO policies lead to people taking less PTO than official PTO policies. So, gotta be careful about that. Why not? Let's go a little bit more. It's not like we don't have the Delta V for it, and that'll give us a little more flexibility. Motivation is a weird, weird thing. Piano Josh, recall that the failure penalty is the penalty paid on top to you having to give back the advance. So it's actually more like double the advance. Unless there's a bug in KSP or contract configurator. So the failure penalty is 1.5x the advance, and then you also have to give back the advance. So you're at zero cash compared to before the advance, and then you also lose 1.5x the advance on top. Where are all my MacJeb windows? What are the limits for this? 8 to 16. Alright, so we will overshoot. Which means you can't set the time for this? That's annoying. If that works. Oh, after the last maneuver. Nope, that's even cheaper. So what do we want to do? We'll have to... Oh, that's right, we can change planes. Increases our inclination. Oh, I have to turn this off so that we actually know how much. 1942. 1940. That seems about right. Blowfish, you're absolutely right. There's literally no reason to have the Vernier if I'm running RCS on this. It dates back to before I remembered I had to put RCS on this. Alright. We could do something fancy burning radial, but instead we're just going to... burn normal to use up the extra delta V. We have to wait until we have comms again. Hopefully we won't use up all the battery. Maybe we should have gone to minus 50 instead of plus 50. Now we have comms. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, it's super weird how this loses angular momentum. Little bit of precession. Fairly exact. Okay. I would have assumed it was from the clipping, because the only time I've seen it is when the stuff is clipped like that. The proc tanks are clipped in, but it's some sort of collider thing where they're producing friction. But, dunno. Alright. 32 days. Alright, I guess we'll launch one more before we have to go to Mars. Pays a little better. That pays decently well. We'll just do that. I don't want to play the slot machine too much. All right. Now we've got two of those launch pads. How much does this cost to upgrade? 250k, we can't afford that yet. We'll want to do it at some point. Yeah, Pap, I'm amazed as well. We are very lucky that things are working. There on the engines. That'll give us some better capabilities. Kind of want to reorganize this. And we'll jump straight to the J-class LMDE if we can. we don't need any of the other cool stuff. Hey, Norcal Planner. Alright. Maintenance costs are impressive here. $13 million a month. That's pretty impressive. The other thing that I want to do, I think, is you should probably pay much lower launch pad maintenance costs if nothing's rolled out to them, and much higher if there is something rolled out to it. Because at the moment, these pads don't care whether something's rolled out. Yeah, our yearly maintenance costs are pretty high. They're like two of those CompSat contracts a year. I think it's the same as last time, like 50 degrees. Above 33 degrees. 8 and 27. Okay, so we don't have to do our craziness. Sorry, this is slightly boring, folks. We're low enough on cash that I don't just want to warp to. Alright, we'll leave everything as it was. Oh, oops. Okay. Whew. Pretty soon, Pap. I think we're almost there. I want to try to verify the starting period myself, which is why I started it today, and I'll grind through it. I think at that point we can merge everything down and look for a release. Finally, almost there. peaceful flight to orbit. Close enough. Alright, that was fairly boring, but it's really time for me to go, so thanks for watching, and catch you next time where we'll do something less boring like launch those Mars probes. But we had to grind up some cash. That was the breaks. Alright, bye-bye.